السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Today I will mention to you a handful or more of individuals have impacted positively on the style of my life and on the values in my life for my life when we started Islamic Leaf in 84 in 517 Mosley Road. I learned a lot from them. I learned a lot from them, and all of them were and are Yemeni. Okay. First one is called Muhammad Musanna, the late Muhammad Musanna rahmatullah alayhi, was a caretaker of the building and the cook as well. Very good cooking he was doing for all of us. And he used to say a very, very golden message to all of us: you are a boss and he is a boss, and who is amongst you will go and treat the donkeys and clean up the place. Every one of you young men, because all of us were actually university students or postgraduate students. He was telling us, all of you are bosses, so who are the workers amongst you? This is Muhammad Musanna, rahmatullah alayhi. Abu Najib had a very golden smile on his face all the time, and had this kind of extremely soft character, and he never upset any one of us. He's living in Yemen now. May Allah protect his life while he is there. And I, while I'm talking to you now, I can remember him talking to me at that time, during that time, actually with his smile and his willingness to help you for doing anything for you. The third one, called Abu Salih Al-Khulaqi. Abu Salih Al-Khulaqi, his smile goes from ear to ear, not actually from cheek to cheek, no. And was very helpful. And his specialty was to buy second-hand cars and sell it to the students, because at that time, all of us as postgraduate students have no much money to buy proper car at that time in the 80s. Al-Faqih Abdul Raqib was in charge of the Islamic circle inside the mosque, and was faqih with the standard, the traditional Yemeni standard at that time. And he used to sit every day or every week to give his circle and to teach people the basic principles of fiqh at that time, with determination that he is alim, and he was alim, rahmatullah alayh. Abu Khalid Al-Muwallad, another character which was very learned, and he had his own opinion, he has his own vision, and he has his own direction, and he loved people to come and visit him at his house in Birmingham to discuss with them his opinion and actually argue about the status of the Muslim and the Arab world at that time, rahmatullah alayh. Al-Amm Hizam, with another smile, like the smile of Abu Salih and the smile of Abu Najib. And he always hospitable, was a very welcoming character to all of us. And he was working also in the 517 or in the Yemeni Institute at that time. And he loved to recite poetry and to write poems at the same time. Amm Saif, Aydan, he had his own van and was driving us from A to B to C to D in a very, very soft character. Very soft. When you look at him, he's always there to help. No noises, no discussion, no argument. And the wife of Dr. Abdullah Shamahi, I think Umm Asma, if I can remember her name, and she was very eager to do the good work, the charitable work, and to raise fund and money, and used to come to us every week or every second week with the money in cash in her hand to give it to us in the office in 517 Mosley Road. You know, when I mention those people who were actually teaching us, people might say, oh, they are not educated like us. They're not qualified for universities. They didn't have any degree. But I tell you, the value of these people for any community and every community is far more valuable than the value of somebody like me with master or PhD who just regurgitate some very, very, very little knowledge in life. So they learned from life. They taught youngsters how to live in life. And they guided all of us at that time with their modesty, with their simplicity, with their humility, with their knowledge, with their experience. So young men and women, my advice to all of you and to each one of you, please, if you found somebody like those people, stick to them, to let them to teach you how to live life inside the living of the life itself, not how to live life according to the books that you read. Each one of them was like an open book for you to take knowledge and experience and guidance and from there. And for those people, rahmatullah alayhim ajma'in, may Allah bless their souls, apart from Saif, Ammu Saif, and Ummu Asma, and Abu Najib was still alive. May Allah bless the souls of the other soul. So please, 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 if you are in my situation, surrounded by those people, these are jewels of community, the pearl of community, and they're diamonds for community. So don't ever undermine them, underestimate their value, and ignore them or sideline them. Jazakumullah khair. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.